Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu syafil anbiya mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Dear brothers and sisters, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity to meet again. I would like to thank all of you for making the university what it is. And today, we are now going to greet the coming of Ramadan, which is tomorrow. I hope this Ramadan, this time around, will give us a new inspiration and a new motivation to move ahead. Certainly, this Ramadan is going to be a bit better than the one last year, where we are now able to do the Taraweeh together in our mosque, something that we have missed for a long time since last year. This is an opportunity for us to make sure that we are together in making what Ramadan is all about as far as the COVID-19 is concerned. The COVID-19 gives us a different perspective of what Ramadan is all about, in the sense that we need now to reaffirm among ourselves that we are able to overcome this pandemic that has been with us for more than a year now. It all boils down on how do we deal with this issue together, and I hope this Ramadan will give us a new spiritual dimension as to how to deal with this. If all this while we've been talking about the physical, the external way of dealing with the COVID-19, now it's time for us to reflect and see what else we can do in the context of making COVID-19 and a losing sort of battle for the virus, so that we can move ahead and make our life a normal life again. In this respect, maybe we need to look up again at the acronym COVID that we have been talking about since last year. The context of C, which is cleanliness. This time it's not just washing hands and keeping external cleanliness, but also the cleanliness of the soul, the mind, and also the thinking process as we go along. I hope this will be the kind of focus that we'll take on as far as this Ramadan is concerned. O is about obedience. Again, in the context this of this Ramadan, we need to be as compliant as possible in trying to create taqwa for ourselves and making this Ramadan a more meaningful, deep-seated values in terms of the practice that we're going to demonstrate for the whole of Ramadan. V is, of course, vigilance. We need to be vigilant, not only in the context of what we talk about, the surrounding, but also the kind of words that we are going to utter, the kind of things that we're going to see, and the kinds of words they're going to listen from others. We need to be very vigilant that we are in a state of cleanliness all along when we talk about this kind of vigilance around us. I is, of course, a question of inclusiveness, how we are going to work together in making this Ramadan a really collective Ramadan, in trying to give as much as possible to the people around us. In this respect, there'll be a project that I will talk to you later when we want to make this Ramadan a meaningful one. Last but not least, certainly, it's a question of discipline. The discipline is something that all of us must adhere to in the context of amanah that we have hold, and to make sure that this Ramadan is really a meaningful one for us. A while ago, I talked about a project that we're going to do and undertake for this Ramadan especially. We are talking about a group of people who is now just beside our university, just outside the gate, which now has been dubbed as Kampung Sejahtera. This refers to a group of 35 families who have been settled around that place for the last 20 years, not knowing that they have been with us very closely for a long time. I am very happy that the regional centers of expertise for sustainable development and also the Sejahtera Center has been dealing with them. And I am now being informed that there will be a project that we will undertake to ensure that this group of people will be looked after for the whole of Ramadan and hopefully beyond. We will make sure that each member of the family will be well fed during this Ramadan, coming from this university and also donations from people around. We will also make sure that the people who are there will be given a kind of a training so that their livelihood will be maintained. I am very proud to announce that one of our collaborators in Selayang will be providing the skills for them to make sure that they are given enough skills so that during this Ramadan they will learn what needs to be learned for them to support their livelihood beyond. We will take care of the children who have been neglected as far as education is concerned, using our school as a base so that they can also be a participant of this university in the time to come. And there are many more projects that have been planned for them. And I do hope and I call on everybody in the university to contact the Regional Centres of Expertise or the Sejahtera Centre if you want to completely immerse yourself in trying to help them and give them whatever they need as far as this university is concerned. This is the spirit of Ramadan that we are trying to build this year so that there is a focus as to what we are doing in trying to help others around us. Certainly all of you will be doing this with other communities, but I think this community that is very close to us needs our attention, and I hope we will be able to make some differences in their life as this Ramadan proceeds, and before it ends, we will make sure that they are resettled somewhere else as far as their livelihood and life is concerned. So on that note, brothers and sisters, this Ramadan is a different one as far as I can see. It'll be a challenging one for us, but nevertheless, this is a spirit of Ramadan that we will need to give, that we need to work together so that we will have the best that we could as far as this Ramadan is concerned. On that note, I wish you Ramadan Mubarak, and I hope we will all be blessed by Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala that this Ramadan becomes a meaningful one for us and it makes some difference to the lives of people around us, if not ourselves, by the virtue that we are going to work together in this month of Ramadan. Thank you very much. Wabillahi taufiq wa hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.